Let's now talk about the US election. 46 days away from the voting day. With each passing day, we have a new controversy and new promises from both sides to win public sentiment. As of the 17th of September, the promise to deliver a Wuhan virus vaccine is what's grabbing headlines. Vaccines have taken center stage. They've turned into a political issue. Donald Trump and Joe Biden are both sparring over a potential vaccine, and they seem to have very little to offer. I'll start with the US president. He has unveiled the largest, the fastest, and the most advanced vaccine distribution plan in American history. These are his words. Under this plan, the Trump administration is promising to swiftly deliver COVID-19 vaccines to all Americans, free of cost. By when? Donald Trump says it's just a matter of weeks.
We're on track to deliver and distribute the vaccine in a very, very safe and effective manner. We think we can start sometime in October. So as soon as it is announced, we'll be able to start. That'll be from mid-October on, maybe a little bit later than that, but we'll be all set.
From mid-October, says the U.S. president, the renewed confidence, I must say, is admirable. Only if American health experts could share the same confidence. Just hours before Donald Trump spoke, the director of the U.S. Center for Disease Control and Prevention, Robert Redfield, testified before a U.S. Congress panel, and he said a vaccine will not be available to the American public before the second and the third quarter of 2021. Listen to this.
I think there will be vaccine that initially be available sometime between November and December, but very limited supply and will have to be prioritized. If you're asking me when is it going to be generally available to the American public so we can begin to take advantage of vaccine to get back to our regular life, I think we're probably looking at late second quarter, third quarter, 2021.
So who should you believe? The commander-in-chief or America's top health expert? We would have thought of an answer backed by facts, but Donald Trump saved us the effort. Listen to him again.
I think he made a mistake when he said that. It's just incorrect information. And I called him, and he didn't tell me that. And I think he got the message maybe confused. Maybe it was stated incorrect. But I don't think he means that. I don't think he, when he said it, I believe he was confused. I'm just telling you, we're ready to go as soon as the vaccine happens. No, he's contradicting himself. I think he misunderstood the questions.
Well, he was testifying.
You know what I think? I think he misunderstood.
Don't you envy his confidence? He made a mistake. He was confused. He didn't mean that. He misunderstood. We are ready to go. To be honest, we cannot really say if Trump is speaking the truth, but whatever it is, we just hope the vaccine he's promising to deliver next month is not that disinfectant which he had promoted as a remedy for the Wuhan virus. And then we have Joe Biden. He has a lot of complaints against President Trump. He says he's fed up with Trump's inaction. Biden wants Trump to take responsibility and come up with a real plan to combat the situation.
All President had to offer last night, President Trump, was the same weak and feckless inaction, the same lies and empty promises that we've seen from the very beginning. He still won't accept any responsibility. He still won't offer a plan. And last night, he repeated what he said so many times before, that even if he continues to offer only failing indifference, someday the virus is going to go away by a miracle. Even if he does nothing, it's going to go away by a miracle.
Then tell us, how will it go away? Biden has a lot to say about Trump's failures, but he offers no solutions. Both men are basically playing to the galleries. Let me give you another example. Earlier this week, we told you how Donald Trump was trying to appease the Hispanic vote bank. He was bragging about some award that he apparently received from Cuban Americans. How he had professed his love for the Latinos on the campaign trail. Joe Biden has taken this appeasement politics to the next level. On his first campaign visit to Florida, he tried courting Hispanic voters. He spoke at length about Trump's quote-unquote divisive immigration policies. He started his address by playing a hit number from 2017, which I'm sure most of you would have heard. You have to watch this.
All right. There you go. Dance a little bit, Joe. Come on.
I'll tell you what, if I had the talent of any one of these people, I'd be
elected president by acclamation. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
There's a reason why we call the U.S. election a reality show. The president is refuting health experts in public. Another presidential hopeful is dancing to Despacito. There's no dearth of entertainment in this race to the White House. We'll keep tracking it for you.